Hello YouTube, my name's Chris, aka the North Umbrian. What I was, there's quite a few in the northeast. They do these bushcraft videos, northeast bushcraft, from Newcastle area, I believe. And there's the fell wanderer who lives about 200 yards away from me. And I was watching his videos when I thought, wait, why didn't I give it a go? So I've come into my local woodland. I recognise this site from one of Phil Wanderer's videos, so I'll show you around in a bit. But I thought I'd give it a go, and it's not easy just speaking to this camera type. But I've lived here only like 57 years, and I've travelled these woods since I was 6 years old, so I kind of know the place pretty well, and I've got a love for the place. But I'm gonna make myself a cup of coffee, and I'll get back to you in a bit. See if I can think of anything to show you, or whatever. Anyway, get to you in a bit. When coffee was brewing, that was tea was brewing, I thought I would gather a little bit of wood for Damien. The fell wanderer, oh, that's wrong, Chris, what are you doing there? Let's take all that longer, but the sheath I made myself. And it's pretty good fit actually. But I stand this wood, it should stay as well. Right, a little bit of firewood there, Damien. I'm going to soak my cup of tea. This is the best bit. Lyle, squeezy syrup. Should I have it that way, shouldn't I? You're right, yeah, I've got a sweet tooth. Picking the woodpecker off. God, I love this place, I really do. The woods, I mean, are great. And no problem. Thank you. That's where it's at. Right, that's where it's at. Come here, that's hot.
Right, I'll speak to you later. Hi again. I've been making knives just for a year a bit, but I only get maybe a couple of hours a week, so I'm not a prolific knife maker. I drive a HGV articulated wheel, so I'm away most of the week. But I'll show you what I've done, show you what some of what I've made. I've actually given some away. But I'll show you some of what I've made anyway. Let's put the camera under me. Start at the beginning, I guess. This was the second knife on me. The first one was made with mild steel, so you couldn't harden it, but it was an exercise in, could I grind the shape, could I fit the handles, would it resemble a knife. And it turned out not too bad, albeit being mild steel, it was an unusual really. This was the second one. I bought some 01 tool steel. I bought some leather, needle stitching, picked up some bits of wood for handles, bits of work and from my local dealers, wood dealers, and this is what I turned out. The pins are actually welding rods. I just knocked the flux off, but they're 4mm. Shaped handle, obviously full Scandi grain, pretty sharp. Now it might look like jack claws and wood claws, but I suppose a craft knife, a bushcraft knife type thing, is wonderful. It's usable, good practical knife, popping sharp. Really sharp, but that was the first one. I suppose the next one was this one here. As you can see, got the stitching in, but I just sort of left the leather and I just put a bit of Vaseline on it. Jimped it. This is Kingwood, I think it's called. That's what it's called, Kingwood. Oh, it's not, it's Pearl Heart, isn't it? Aye. Brass pins, 8mm lanyard wool. I mean, they're not heirloom type knives, but I call this the Camp Cutler, camp knife. It'll prepare meat, rabbits, it'll do the bones. It's 4mm 01 tool steel. Jimp the top for a good grip. But it'll split wood. And it'll prepare food. The next one's the same knife, just much more refined, I think. Corian. Scales. Haven't jimped it. So this is still a Camp Cutler, but it looks more like a kitchen knife with the weight. It is a kitchen knife sort of shaped handle, isn't it? But what a grip you get with this Corian. This the way I've shaped this. Nice knife. That's a mistake I made. You get the mark on the metal here off the stud, which is off the knife retaining strap.
forgot to put on the inside of the, before I covered it, a piece of leather. But that's, I think that's the nicest sheath I've made. That pretty good. That sits pretty high on the hip. It's not bad. Anyway, next one. This is supposed to be held in to the sheath with friction. Not mint. The back stitched, drain hole. But this one is actually called the Tut, because my nephew designed it. He drew it on a scrap bit of paper. I mean, I'm saying my nephew, he's not like 12, he's 36, 37, so he's not a kid, but he actually wanted to make it, but he didn't have time, so I turned it out for him. But like I said, they're not heirloom type pieces, they're usable knives. And it's 01 tool steel, that's all I've used up to now. Swedge the top, I think they call that. And that's a bit of a... All my knives are sort of scandi grain, but a lot of them have got a micro bevel. Sharp as bloody hell. Anyway. And the sheath, single fold over, but I did put a welt in it. Bit slack. I'm not using that design again. Leave a smaller footprint as possible, I suppose, for a reusable camp. Excellent. Didn't believe that. That took some holding steady, because that. Anyway, I'm going to head off, and I'll see you later. Bye for now.